Hi everybody, this is Nick. I got a question over on one of our YouTube short videos about how you can separate or split one object into two using animation, or in this case, I'm gonna use the morph transition. You can do this a couple of different ways, and it just depends on how you wanna split that object up. So here we just have a very simple circle on our slide. I'm gonna push the advance key just to go on to the next slide, have some morph animation here, and you can see it's gonna split this circle into two different circles right there, and they go right off the slide. A pretty cool effect. Now, the other way that you could do this is split the circle in half and have those halves move in any direction that you wanted to. So I could split the circle in half like this, and it would move across the screen. So there's two different ways that you can think about splitting one object into two, and you can do this in multiple parts too. It doesn't have to just be into two separate things. It could be into as many different shapes as you want to. I'm gonna escape out of this slide, and we're gonna go ahead, and I'm gonna make this slide from scratch down here. So we're gonna go over here to and insert a new slide. And I'm gonna go to this one. Now we're in normal view here. The thing that we're gonna do first, we're gonna do the morph animation where we have one circle turn into two tiny circles and fly off the screen. So what we're first gonna do is insert a circle shape. I'm gonna go ahead and position it perfectly. I'm gonna make it exactly how I want it to look. And let's just keep it blue. I'm gonna go ahead and get rid of the outline just because I never like those outlines. And what we're gonna do in this case, we're actually gonna duplicate it. So push Control D to duplicate that circle. Make sure that it goes right on top of the other one so they're both completely together. If you wanna make sure they're both completely overlapping, highlight the entire thing so both of them are selected. Use your arrange tools to align them center and align them to the middle. Now they're perfectly on top of each other. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna duplicate this slide. So make sure that all of your circles are created. We have two circles here. We're gonna duplicate this slide by pushing Control D. And now what we're gonna do is we are going to resize them. I move them, you can move them however you want to do. I'm gonna resize them because I want them to become a little bit smaller. And I'm gonna hold down the Shift key to proportionally resize them just a little bit lower. Now let's go up here, and so they're right here in the middle of the slide. Now let's go ahead and apply the morph transition to this second slide. Go to the transition and click on morph, and now you can see it gives you a preview. It takes those two, we're kind of tricking PowerPoint, or kind of tricking our audience really, into thinking that we have one shape that turns into two, but actually we still just have two shapes that turn into two, that turn into the same thing, they're just being resized. So then if I were to play this in slideshow mode, click advance the slide, and now both of those circles turn in. It's a pretty cool effect, and I bet you can figure out or think of some other ways that you might use this in a presentation. Let's go ahead and do the other technique now too. I'm gonna go ahead and insert a new slide. We're gonna insert that blank layout here. Let's go ahead and start from scratch again. I'm gonna go ahead and insert my circle. I'm gonna resize it just so I want it. Let's remove that outline again too. And now what we're gonna do, this is the technique where the circle is gonna split in half and go off of the screen. So what we need to do now is just split the circle in half, and we can do that using the merge shapes tools and with the help of a helper shape here. So I'm gonna insert a rectangle. We don't care, this rectangle we're gonna delete at the end, but we need it to split this circle in half. So I'm gonna go ahead and just, let's recolor it orange just so we can see it. And I wanna make sure that the rectangle is right at that cut point, right in the middle, or right where I would want to split the circle. And I think that looks pretty good. You're just gonna have to eyeball it. If you wanted to make it really exact, I think you could do some measurements with that ruler above. Now what we're gonna do is click on that circle, hold down the Shift key, and then click on the rectangle. Now, up in the Shape Format tab, you're gonna go over to Merge Shapes, and we're gonna click on Fragment. When you do this, it fragments everything, kind of like a cookie cutter. So now we have a bunch of little shapes based on the two overlapping shapes that we had there. And I can go ahead and I can get rid of that rectangle, I don't need it. But now you can see that if you click here, you have two different shapes, kind of like those half ovals. So now what I'm gonna do, use the morph transition again. We're gonna duplicate this slide once. Now on this slide here, we are going to apply the morph transition. And now we can move, on the second side, we can move these however we want to. Now one trick is, if you wanna move them, you can just of course click and drag them, but if you hold down the Shift key, you can actually, it'll drag it, but it'll only allow you to drag it horizontally on that plane so that it stays on that exact sort of vertical or horizontal path. pretty cool. So hold down the shift key, drag it all up. Oop, I had that one highlighted too. I gotta make sure that this one is highlighted, and then hold down shift and then drag it off the slide. Oop, sometimes it's, there we go, perfect. Now, let's go back here to our first slide, put it in slideshow mode. I'm gonna advance the slide and watch the two shapes split apart. Perfect, a really cool transition. Now, if you wanted to make that split a little bit faster, you can see up here in the transition tab over here, the duration of that morph is 2 seconds. If we wanted it to be really, really short, you can go down to 0.25 seconds, and let's see what that looks like. I'm gonna advance the slide. Perfect, and it goes whiz right off the screen. So I hope that you like this video. If you do, give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. Had a great time making this for you, and I hope to see you all next time.